僕はできないんだけど。
Maybe we can start with this first seminar of the CDF. So, seminar. はい。まあ、最初のセミナーなので、これちょっとラフなタイトルにしましたけど、英語で15分だけ喋ります。で、ディスカッションは日本語で。So today I proposed the hypothesis on the eastward propagation mechanism of the MGO from a case study of the October MGO during Cindy in 2011. The hypothesis is like this. We have the onset of the MGO over the Indian Ocean on 21st to 25th October, and we have a low pressure system associated with the MGO over the Equatorial Indian Ocean. And at the same time, we have the exotropical cyclone over the southern Indian Ocean. From the southern tip of the African continent, around 30 degrees south, and it moves eastward at the same speed of the Madden-Julian oscillation. The wind speed of the exotropical cyclone is 6 meters per second. It's just the same as the speed of the MGO, and on the 4th November, the October MGO moving eastward over and reach up to the Maritime continent, and extratropical cyclone moves at the same time, just south of the MGO. Over the Australian continent. So, why did they propagate eastward? On this hypothesis, extratropical cyclone is associated with the westerly anomalous westerlies in the behind of the extratropical cyclone, because pressure gradient force from the high pressure to low pressure system. So we have anomalous western western winds around here, and it comes over from mid latitude to the subtropics, and west anomalous westerlies broaden over the equator region, and it merged with the Madden-Julian oscillation over the southern East Indian Ocean, and we have the zonal component of the surface convergence like this. It's something kind of a cold front from the extratropical cyclone, and it's merged and extending to the MGO center, and it moves. It easily pushed the MGO convection eastward, and then we have the synchronicity between the MGO low pressure system and the extratropical cyclone system is observed in these cases. So this hypothesis is simply explained from just three figures, time longitude cross section, and some samples of horizontal distributions and vertical distributions. Totally 11 panels. Only 11 panels. So, looking at the first time longitude cross section of the cerebral pressure anomaly with color and zonal component of surface convergence with black contour, and the ORR of 210 watt per square meter by red contours here, like this, and we have October MGO, its onset is the 31st October, and it moves eastward until the 120 degrees east, and its phase speed is around 6 meters per second. And let's look at the orange colors here. We have the anomalous low pressure system. It's huge. It's with a Brandt scale of its width more than 10,000 kilometers. It moves eastward at 12 meters per second. It's like a phase speed of carbon waves. And within this low pressure system, we have the MGO onset in the late October. And it. Okay, I explain later. So this is this. So in this study, I define the anomaly. Which is different from usual use. This is called the normalized anomaly. We have a variable, and anomaly from the 30 days mean running mean the day before these variables. So we have the just this is the usual anomalies, right? And normalized by the standard deviation for the running 30 days. So this is for the elimination of the latitude dependence of the variables, because cerebral pressure has different amplitudes over the equator and the mid latitude. So usually we couldn't see the significant features of the sea level pressure signal of associated with the MGO, but using this normalized anomaly, we can
sorry. If the disturbance is sinusoidal wave, your definition will derive probably a constant.
Okay, please don't interrupt 50 minutes.
Okay.
Just 50 minutes.
Yeah, only the question
or
the definition.
Just three figures. So we can easily see that low pressure propagation is what propagation of the over the equator, and it's entirely synchronicity over the southern hemisphere, 30 degrees south to 10 degrees south, but not over the northern hemisphere like this. Okay, and of course, we have convergence associated with the MGO is moving eastward at the same time, and also it appeared over the southern hemisphere at the same time. It's clear, but it's not over the southern hemisphere, between 10 degrees north to 30 degrees north. So looking at the representative horizontal distribution at the initial stage of the MGO, 25th October here and 4th November here, is like this. This is the horizontal distribution of the sea level pressure, normal sea level pressure anomaly. And the sea level pressure by Bragg contours, it's usual. We have extratropical cycle here. And red contours is ORR of the MGO. It's here. We have the onset of the MGO on the 25th October. And all this system is embedded in the large scale of low pressure system in the anomaly, normalized anomaly field on 25th October. And after the propagation of the MGO on 4th November, we have the eastward shift of the entire low pressure system only over the southern hemisphere. It's simultaneously a chord of the eastward propagation is here and also over the Australian continent. So it means a trough, deep trough, is extending from south to the American continent here. So within this field, we have anomalous field like this, and we have anomalous westerlies behind the low pressure system here. This is the anomalous westerly, only positive westerly is shown here, and color means the zonal component of surface convergence. The surface convergence is associated just ahead of the westerly, anomalous westerly, like this. It's extending from the exotropical cyclone to the tropics here. Orange colors is convergence. We have an enormous western here. You cannot see?
Yes. 申し訳ない
ですよね。はい、じゃあ、あとで。はい。で、this convergence, zone and component of convergence ahead of the west, anomalous westerlies moved eastward on the, on to 4th November like this. It just synchronized with each other over the equator and the exotropics, subtropics. So, extended region is here, and remaining 3 minutes more. So, I just show the vertical cross section over the center of the MGO and the western part of the MGO. We have four panels. This is the left panel is the geopotential anomaly, normalized geopotential anomaly. Red colors, warmer color means lower pressure, and blue color means higher pressure. And black contour is relative humidity. It means the convection associated with MGO. We have the huge convection associated with the MGO like this. It's a and the right panel is anomalous westerlies by color, and the contour is absolute westerlies. So please look at the western part of the MGO. We have a barotropic structure of the anticyclone of the it's associated with Muscombe High is over the Indian Ocean, but for the central part of the MGO over the Maritime continents, we have exotropical cyclone, lower pressure system is extending from the southern hemisphere to the equator. It's associated with exotropical cyclone. And associated with that, we have western jet streams. And of course, it appears in the both hemisphere. This is a subtropical jet, western wind jet. Usually, western winds of the subtropical jet has deep westerly winds, but it's separated with the separated is the eastern winds over the over the subtropics. Between the 20 degrees south to 10 degrees south over the both hemisphere here, like this. Only for the over the equator we have some westerlies associated with MGO behind MGO. This is a kind of westerly belt called it's called westerly belt. But for the central part of the MGO, we have the anomalous westerlies, continuous anomalous westerlies from the south. Not only for the anomalous one, but absolute westerly. Zero contour is here, like this. Continuous westerly wind field is extended from the south to the equator. So, just summarizing such description, I just proposed that like this, and particularly, and for the western part of the MGO, we usually just MGO is a cloud between the high high pressure system in the subtropics, like Muscarine High and another one in the northern hemisphere. And the low pressure system over the equator, it makes some convection, like this streamline. Then we have a western subtropical jet in the both hemisphere, and only for the lowest layers, just behind the MGO. It's this separated by the eastern winds, like this. But at the but for the center of the MGO, exotropical cyclone system, low pressure system, is continuously extending from for the equator to the equator, and the western winds fields, it doesn't isn't separated by the eastern winds like this. So western winds dominates over the southern hemisphere entirely, dominates even in the upper air over the for the central part of the MGO. This kind of hypothesis is 18 minutes is passed. Is supported recent several studies. So my hypothesis is like this. It's just simply speaking, exotropical cyclone over the southern Indian Ocean just pushed the MGO to the eastward. This is the simple hypothesis from a case study. Hi, すいません。日本語でどうぞ。
途中出てきたやつの説、はい、その例えば赤い線は何ですか今の延直ダウン。
じゃあ最初から行きましょう。まあ、この15分は言うのもダメなので。
何の偏差なのかとか、その矢印がどこの高さなのかとかを一応言ってくれないと。
全部サーフェスです。で、偏差は全て、
その地点での、
その地点での、30日ランニング便です。ランニング便からの偏差を取っています。30日ランニングのスタンダードディビエーションを技術的に作って、それで規格化しています。
そこで僕が聞いたのは、そのもし行乱が三角関数、1個の三角関数だとしたら、シグマは振幅のルート2分の1になるのかな。だからなんかその、行乱の形によってこの定義っていうのは、だからなんか左右されるんじゃないのかな。それはね。
わかりません。行乱の形とか、どっちに連発するか一切仮定してないということです。単純に移動依存性だけを除去したって、それだけです。
仮定じゃなくて、もし三角、X がね、サインとかコサインとかの1個の三角関数だったら、もうその値決まってしまうんじゃないかなと。No?
You mean if it becomes, it's not a concept, you mean it could be normalized?
Ah, yes. But how to say, it is dependent on the shape of the disturbance.
No.
You don't need?
Yeah. No, but then, why 30 days? Is it sensitive to this short?
It's just, actually, 60, more than 6 days is similar results we get. But at least 30 days necessary, I think, because I want to describe the MGO related fields. But I tried several patterns over 6 days, 20 days, 30 days, more than 100 days. More than 100 days is into different fields.
I think that was
the So
the, is it,
in the beginning, what's the meaning of bar? Bar is zonal mean or time mean?
Time average.
Time average of
each. Running time average.
Running time average.
For the 30 days.
So that may be a problem.
At each all grids, at each all grids, for the temporal 30 days running we get. And temporal 30 days running standard deviation we get.
But 30 days is a little bit shorter than typical period of NGO.
I don't know.
I don't know which is true. What do you want to do?
So I tried anything. 10 days, 20 days, 30 days, 60 days. But it's not different.
いや、何
を目的として
30
日の経験を取ったの？まずですね、30日は別にあの便宜的なもんですけど、ただあまり短すぎるものは除いてる。